Hi, this is Sheshanand. I want to explain one more application with microcontroller, which is token system using microcontroller. So this application, which contains three blocks as power supply and microcontroller unit and display part, I am taking display as 7-segment unit and switch. So whenever user operating a switch, then token number will increment automatically. So from this application, I'll explain the individual blocks. One is power supply unit. The power supply unit contains different blocks internally again, which is rectifier, filter and regulator. Bridge rectifier converts your AC to DC, but it is not pure DC, it is a pulsating DC. So this DC, which is filtered through electrolytic capacitors, as the basic property of capacitor, it allows AC and blocks DC. The remaining block DC will given to regulator unit, and regulators gives constant output irrespective of any input. So this constant DC source you are connecting to all individual components from the hardware. And microcontroller, which also have some internal connections as reset circuit components. Crystal oscillator is needed between 18 and 19 pins and power supply connections. By connecting all these reset mandatory connections, you can add your peripherals with the microcontroller. There are switches. So now I am using only one button to increment the count as token number, and 7-segment unit I am using for display purpose. So whenever the person wants to increment or call the next token, then simply press the switch, then the token number will increment automatically on the 7-segment. I'll show you the circuit diagram. So before proceeding circuit diagram, let's see this lookup table for your 7-segment devices. So I think you are aware of 7-segments are available with two types, common anode and common cathode. The common anode, all segments anode end is given to VCC, and the cathode ends you need to operate with program. So if you are expecting any number from 7-segment devices, so in the case of common anode, you have to provide logic 0 for your cathode leads. So as per expected number, you have to make sure zeros and ones from your 7-segment devices. So this table follows the numbers 0 to 9 and respective hexadecimal values. So you cannot assign to display 0 as 0 for your data lines. If you are expecting any number on 7-segment, you should know about these values. Until unless you are not aware of these values from your 7-segment, no chance to display any numbers. So it may be garbage or it may be any just random numbers. So if you are trying to display proper numbers, you should aware of these hexadecimal values you need to assign for your A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H segments. So for 0, 0xC0 is the value. So in the case of 0, only G and H segments are off, remaining all segments are on. And in the case of F9, only B and C segments on, remaining all segments are off. So the value is F9. In the case of 2, this A, B, D, E and G, these segments will on, remaining segments off. See, to turn off the segment, I am giving logic 1. To turn on the segment, I am giving logic 0 in the case of common anode. So if you are working with common cathode, just you have to change your logics. In the case of common cathode, you have to give your common pin to ground, and anode ends you need to manage with your programming. That time you have to provide logic 1s in the case of common cathode. So that you have to take care. So these values I just given the table for 0 to 9 numbers. C0, F9, A4, B0, 99, 92, 82, F8, 80, 90. These are values for 0 to 9. Next, the circuit I am giving here, which is designed from Proteus simulation tool. The circuit connections are very clear. From 2 digit 7 segment, there are common data lines and 2 common pins. So these common data lines from 2 segments A, B, C, D, F, G, H, I just connected with one complete port from microcontroller, which is port 2. And the 2 common pins I given to P3.0 and 3.1. And the button connection I given to P1.0. So before proceeding source code, you should be aware of how to design the circuit from hardware. So now, as per this application, as a user, if you are operating this button, then next token will be displayed on this 2 digit 7 segment. If you are working with huge numbers, then you can go with 4 digit, 6 digit, 8 digit, multiple 7 segment programming. As prototype, I am showing you 2 digit 7 segment display with one button. Now, coming to the source code of this application, the source code which is already developed in Keil Microvision IDE. So, this IDE supports to develop programs for microcontroller families. Keil Microvision is one of the most popular IDE in embedded technology. So this IDE will supports to write the program, compile the program, debug the program and create executable file which is .hex from embedded development. So you have to create .hex file to load your program into microcontrollers. But you can use two languages to write the program for microcontrollers. One is assembly language and embedded C also. But embedded C is the most familiar one for everyone. They can easily understand with the knowledge of C language. The embedded C is quite is more similar to your C language. Syntaxes, keywords, everything is common from C language to embedded C. But one difference, it is cross development. Embedded is always comes under cross development because here there is a specific target. You should develop your programs based on your target device, not generalized programs. So now I am including the first line, which is reg51.h. So based on this, you can understand the embedded C programming starts with specific target devices, which is reg51.h is the header file name for all 51 families. So which supposed to use all SFR registers without any declaration in programs. So SFR registers, you have SFR registers for all individual features from microcontroller. Even you are working with ADC, PWM, IO ports, timers, counters, interrupts, any feature you are working with microcontroller, you should be aware of SFRs. Once you have better knowledge on SFR registers, you can program any feature from microcontroller. So now there are two individual declarations, sbit.com1 which is equal to P3.3.0. This is a syntax you need to use to define one single bit from SFR registers. But SFR register should be bit addressable. If register is not bit addressable, you cannot access one single bit from SFR register. If register is bit addressable, then only you can access by using this sbit. For two common pins, I am taking two individual IOs and declaration with sbit data type, which is COM1 P3 caps 0 and COM2 this is P3 caps 1, and the data lines A, B, C, D, F, G, H I connected with complete port so that I'll use port name in program directly. And one another declaration for switch or button. So button is connected with P1.0 from hardware so that I'm declaring in program. And one user defined function which is delay. And main logic starts from here. So So I am taking three temporary variables, v1, v2, v3, and the lookup table values you need to save with array, because every time if you are incrementing your count, then you should increment the index of array. Anyway, these values, which are equivalent to 0 to 9 numbers for your 7 segment, and the initial assignment of port 2, which is used for data lines, initial declaration is 00. Now, while of 1. So this is an infinite loop. Once the compilation enters into this loop, which is keep on executing. So let's see this condition. The condition I am writing here, if button equals t equals to 0, I am incrementing one variable value by 1. But this will increment in hexadecimal format. So you have to separate one byte value into two digits, because you have two digit display from hardware. Suppose the value is 0x00, then you have to separate as 0 and 0. So to separate one byte value into two digits, I am following this quotient and remainder concept. So one variable value I am separating as two digits with v2 and v3. If you are finding quotient for that existence variable value, suppose if it is 0, then you will get remainder 0, quotient 0. So two digits allows to display 00. If count value is 1, which is 0x01 in hexadecimal format, so that if you are finding remainder and quotient, you will get quotient as 0 and remainder as 1 for 1. So I separated at two digits, 0 and 1. So these two variable values I'll follow with this index. So first common pin I'm activating to display first number on first segment. So by activating first common pin, then the respective value I'm trying to display with this data lines, segment of V2, which means if V2 value becomes 0, then it allows to read the element from this array as C0, so that segment allows to display 0. And based on V3 value, the second digit will allows to print your number. Suppose it is 1, then it allows to read this first element of your array, which is segment of 1. So every time I am trying to switch this common 1 and common 2 with some time delay, and this delay should be very less, because 7 segments you have to manage with proper time delays. If delay is not set properly, then you cannot get proper display from your 7 segments. So whenever you are handling multiple 7 segments, delays will play the major role. So these two segments will allow us to print your numbers based on V2 and V3, followed by your index 00, 01, 02, 03 as per your V1 variable. When this V1 variable is going to increment? Whenever user is operating button, otherwise it will hold the previous count. Then segments, they can display your previous number only. So the output of this program I'll show you with this Proteus simulation tool. So Proteus simulation tool is one of the more popular simulation tool. Generally, simulation means you can check your hardware results with the help of software. So even industries follow the same procedure to get the product. They never approach directly hardware. If you want to test their output, first they will design the circuit with this kind of tools, and they will check output, then they will proceed with hardware. The same scenario, you can check it here. The output of your embedded C program, you can check with this simulation tool. But you cannot link .c files or .asm files. You need to link your hex file. So that hex file you need to create by using Keil Microvision IDE. So after linking your hex file, just play your design. See, I am not giving any input from user side, so display remains 00. Whenever user is operating button one time, then count increment by 1, next 2, 3, 4. So how many times you are going to close and release the button, then count it is keep on incrementing. If user is not operating this button, no change from your token display. So like to call the next person, you can simply press the button, the count token number will change on this 7 segment display. So this is for only 2 digits. So if you want to design for 4 digits or 6 digits, also you can easily design the same concept. So this is how your token system works. See how many times the user is operating this button. So that particular time, if you are pressing the button and releasing the button, then token number will increment automatically. So for more videos, please subscribe our channel Eritex Solutions from YouTube. Please give your valuable feedback through comment. Please share and like our videos. Any embedded system training related activities, you can get back with this number 9676327118. Even if you are doing placement support for experienced people, and we will do projects, and you're doing your own products with microcontroller based applications. And if you want to reach us, just go through this address. You are located in Housing Board near KPHP Metro Station, Kukatpally, Hyderabad. Any queries, please write an email us, ysnanda@eritexsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.